This Holy Eucharist, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, is offered for all the souls for whom we pray at this Eucharistic celebration. And we shall also pray for the souls who do not have anyone, souls who are not remembered. We also remember at this Eucharist and pray for them. So all people who have offered the Mass for all their family souls, we pray for them at this Eucharist. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, November 2nd, we remember all the departed souls. Yesterday we celebrated the solemnity of All Saints, and we gave thanks to God for all the saints. And today we, in a special way, remember all the faithful departed souls, all those who believed in Jesus Christ and they have died. They are no more in their lives, and we pray for them so that they may attain the state of heavenly about in their life, that their souls may be rest in peace in heaven with the Heavenly Father. To celebrate the sacred mystery of God's love, let us call to mind our sins and ask for God's pardon and forgiveness. I confess to Almighty God,
and to my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my faults, through my most grievous faults. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Listen kindly to our prayers, O Lord, and as our faith in your Son, raised from the dead, is deepened, so may our hope of resurrection for your departed servants also find new strength through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will prepare for all peoples a banquet of rich food. On this mountain, he will remove the mourning veil covering all peoples, and the shroud enwrapping all nations. He will destroy death forever. The Lord will wipe away the tears from every cheek. He will take away his people's shame. Everywhere on earth, for the Lord has said so. That day it will be said, "See, this is our God, in whom we hoped for salvation. The Lord is the one in whom we hoped. We exult and we rejoice that he has saved us." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response will be, "The Lord is my light and my help." Please repeat.
The Lord is my light and my help.
The Lord is my light and my help. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Before whom shall I shrink? Our response.
The Lord is my light and my help.
There is one thing I ask of the Lord, for this I long: to live in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to savor the sweetness of the Lord, to behold his temple. Our response.
The Lord is my light and my help.
O Lord, hear my voice when I call. Have mercy and answer. It is your face, O Lord, that I seek. Hide not your face. Our response.
The Lord is my light and my help.
I am sure I shall see the Lord's goodness in the land of the living. Hope in him, hold firm and take heart. Hope in the Lord. Our response.
The Lord is my light and my help.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Hope is not deceptive, because the love of God has been poured into our hearts by the Holy Spirit, which has been given us. We are still helpless when at his appointment, moment Christ died for sinful men. It is not easy to die even for a good man. Though, of course, for someone really worthy, a man might be prepared to die. But what proves that God loves us is that Christ died for us while we were still sinners. Having died to make us righteous, it is likely that he would now fail to save us from God's anger. When we were reconciled to God by the death of his Son, we were still enemies. Now that we have been reconciled, surely we might count on every being saved by the life of his Son. Not merely because we have been reconciled, but because we are filled with joyful trust in God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have already gained our reconciliation. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Kindly arise for the gospel. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
Praise be the Lord. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Praise be the Lord. Praise be the Lord. Alleluia. Praise be the Lord. Alleluia. Praise be the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory be to you, O Lord.
Jesus exclaimed, I bless you, Father, Lord of heaven and of earth, for hiding these things from the learned and the clever and revealing them to mere children. Yes, Father, for that is what it pleased you to do. Everything has been entrusted to me by my Father, and no one knows the Son except the Father, just as no one knows the Father except the Son and those to whom the Son chooses to reveal him. Come to me, all you who labor and are overburdened, and I will give you rest. Shoulder my yoke and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. Yes, my yoke is easy and my burden light. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear sisters and brothers in Christ Jesus, in the life of our Catholic Church, we have the practice of praying for the departed souls. How we picked up this practice of praying for the departed souls in our families, even in our Catholic Church, in the liturgical celebrations. We have an obvious example in the Old Testament, especially in the book of Maccabees, the last book of the Old Testament, Maccabees, where the people of God, the people of Israel, they offered sacrifice for the people who were dead in their families, and they offered prayer for them, and they were praying to God for the departed souls of their family members. And the important thing that they did when they were praying for their dead in the family, they used to help the poor and the needy. Why they used to help the poor and the needy? So that God may have mercy on the departed soul, and whatever sin the departed soul might have done may be forgiven by God, and the soul attains heaven. The soul goes to God. And we in the Catholic Church picked up this, and in the liturgical celebrations of the whole year, we offer Mass for the departed souls of our family members, of our relatives, or someone whom is very closer to you at the Eucharist. Every day we offer, even on Sunday we offer. But the Church, in the liturgical celebration, in the liturgical worship, is giving one special day, that is November 2nd, after the Feast of All Saints. The second day, we pray for all souls. Why we have to pray for all souls after the Feast of All Saints? Because in the Gospel, Jesus tells that no one should perish in this world. God wants everybody to be restored. Nobody should be perished because of their sins that they have committed in this world. So God had a will, He had a kind of desire that all the people must be saved from their death, from their perish, So he sent his son Jesus Christ into the world so that people, by believing in Jesus Christ, they may attain eternal life. They may attain glory. So Jesus very clearly said, "This is my Father's will that nobody, no one of you should be perished in your life for which I came into this world." And secondly, we can see, my dear brothers and sisters, Jesus telling, "Unless a place has been prepared in heaven, I would not tell you why I'm here, so that I may take all of you to heaven where the place is prepared for all of you. You are the sons and daughters of God. You are not supposed to be perished in hell. You are supposed to live with the Heavenly Father, because my Father is a living God. So all the people of God must be living." Say, they must have eternal life. That's why we say, for a Christian, for a believer, death is not the end. Death is the beginning of a new life in heaven with the Heavenly Father. And Jesus very clearly says, even St. Paul in his letter, he says that our home is not this world, because this world is not permanent. Our home is heaven. All of us, we are living in this world. We are preparing ourselves to attain our home. The permanent home is heaven. So that means we are people of heaven. We are not people of hell. That's why the church is insisting, that the church is asking us that we may pray for the departed souls so that they may be forgiven of their sins and they may all go to heaven, not to hell. Now I want to tell you, in our Catechism of the Catholic Church, in our Catechism of our Catholic Church, we have a three state. Okay? First is, we have a hell, then we have a purgatory, then we have heaven. Now what is this purgatory that we are talking about? Purgatory is a state of purification. So that means our own family members, maybe our fathers, our mothers, our brothers and sisters, uncles, aunties, okay, when they die, some of them, even after their death, they are living in sin. The souls are in sin. So they are in the state of purification, in the purgatory. So those who are living in this world, the family members, what do? They are praying for their family members so that God may forgive their sins and they may be purified of their sins in their life after their death. Then the soul, okay, the departed souls may, after having forgiven by God in that purgatory, then they go to heaven. They don't go to that eternal damnation that is in hell. That's why you might have heard, there is a parable called the parable of that there's a banquet of a bridegroom. There we see that the owner, okay, he says, "Send this fellow to that place where there will be weeping of grinding of teeth." There will be a weeping and grinding of teeth. So what does it mean? No? A weeping and grinding of teeth. So that is a place of hell. My dear friends, in hell, there is an eternal fire. The fire is always 24 hours in an extinguishing. Sorry, it's burning. And the people who are, suppose in hell, they are constantly in sufferings because of that eternal fire in the hell. But in heaven, there is always a joy. There is always a happiness. There is always an eternal bliss. So all these saints who are in heaven with the Heavenly Father, they are always happy. They are rejoicing. They are joyful with the Heavenly Father. In heaven, you cannot find any sorrows. You cannot find any sufferings. You cannot find any kind of problems, difficulties. So, This day is given for all of us by the brothers and sisters. We are living. One day we are also going to die. That's why you can see one inscription, you know, in the grave, in cemetery when you go. Today I am, tomorrow you. Like today, you know, they have, no more. Tomorrow we will also will be no more. So they write that, okay? Today I am, tomorrow you will be. So we need to pray for this faithful departed, let us all. We say they are faithful. They are faithful in Jesus Christ. Yet because of, you know, their sins, because of, you know, their sinful life, these souls are still, you know, waiting to attain, to reach that heaven. So we need to continually, constantly, you know, pray for them till, you know, they reach heaven in their life. So let us pray at this Eucharistic celebration that we remember all our family souls today in a special way, and we pray for them, we remember them, and we do some charitable work, you know, in remembrance of, you know, them, so that they may be forgiven of their sins and God may have mercy on them and give them eternal rest. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this bread. We offer you fruit of the earth, work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
By the mystery of this water and wine, we share the divinity of Christ, who accompanied himself in our humanity.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this wine. We offer you fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Lord, we ask you to be pleased with the sacrifice we offer you with humble and contrite of hearts. Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be accepted to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Look favorably on our offerings, O Lord, so that your departed servants may be taken up into glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the salvation of the world, the life of the human race, the resurrection of the dead. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May your voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord,
God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it
and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Oswald Ignatius, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servants, for all souls, for all the faithful departed souls, we pray at this Eucharist. Remember them, have mercy on the faithful departed souls, and grant them eternal rest. Take them with you in heaven, so that they may experience your heavenly bliss and joy and peace of their lives. They may also intercede, pray for all of us whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that they who were united with your Son in a death like this may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Let us pray for all the departed souls of our family today, as we are celebrating this Eucharist for them. that God may grant them eternal rest for their souls, and they may always experience the mercy and the love of God, because Jesus said, "My yoke is easy, my burden light." Yes, God may take away all our family members who are no more their burden, and they may always experience the lightness of their life. Together we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said His apostles, "Peace, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever."
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you. Lamb of God,
take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
May this mingling of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring eternal life to us who receive it. May the receiving of your body and blood, Lord Jesus Christ, not bring me to judgment and condemnation, but through your loving mercy be for me protection in mind and body and a healing remedy. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are we who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Spiritual communion prayer. O Lord Jesus, since I cannot now receive you in your sacramental presence, I beg you to come spiritually into my soul to enrich me with your holy grace and make me truly your own forever. O Jesus, living in Mary, come and live in me in the spirit of your holiness, in the communion of your mysteries, in the perfection of your ways. O divine guest, give to my soul a strong, lively faith, an unbounded trust, perfect humility, and abiding sorrow for my sins, a total abandonment to your divine will, and a perfect loving union with your mind and heart. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that your departed servants, for whom we have celebrated this Paschal sacrament, may pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May the God of all consolation bless you, for in his unfathomable goodness he created the human race, and in the resurrection of his only begotten Son, he has given believers the hope of rising again.
Amen.
To us who are alive, may God grant pardon for our sins, and to all the dead, a place of light and peace.
Amen.
So may we all live happily forever with Christ, whom we believe truly rose from the dead.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus, you are
Jesus, you are.